ECV technique in practice. The patient is placed with the bed tilted in 20 degrees head down position. A pillow is placed underneath the knees to relax the abdominal muscles. The partner is involved in the process by sitting at the foot end. We prefer a filled rather than an empty bladder, which makes it easier to lift the fetal breech from the maternal pelvis. An intravenous injection with tocolytics is administered. A warm ultrasound gel is applied to the mother's abdomen. Two obstetricians perform the ECV as they are working as a team. The first obstetrician, focusing on the fetal head, identifies the fetal head. We ask the mother to relax and take a deep breath in and out. When exhaling, the second obstetrician, concentrating on the fetal breech, tries to lift the breech out of the pelvis. After succeeding, this obstetrician only focuses on having a firm hold on the baby's buttocks and stabilizing this new position. The first obstetrician, focusing on the fetal head, tries to manipulate the head with a pull movement in the turning direction. In order to prevent too much pressure on the fetus, these movements are consecutive rather than simultaneous. Simultaneously, the progression of the attempt and the fetal heart rate are monitored by ongoing ultrasound by a biometric nurse. When repeating these attempts by both obstetricians, one after the other, the baby will turn. After the baby has turned approximately 45 degrees, grip on the fetal head is lost in the pull movement, and a change of hands position into a push movement is made. The same principle applies to the fetal buttocks, where the other obstetrician also changes hands position from a pull movement into a push movement. Every attempt is registered by a study nurse, who meticulously registers all events for scientific analysis.